So yeah, how to get started? Like I've told you, like more like industry, so many things are there. It's like so confusion, like where you start from. So definitely you'll go start working on your computer and you'll see so many things out there. Like it will be a confusing situation. So definitely go and watch tutorials. Like definitely you can find stuff on YouTube. And you can go and do some online course, like Skillshare is there, like some Pinterest. I'm using Cinema 4D a lot for my work. So I watch Cinema 4D tutorials or like Cinema 4D forums. Use Behance as your best guide. You can watch some work. There's another one, Pluralsight. That's definitely worth it. Vimeo is another one. And this one is Grayscale Gorilla. You can watch tutorials for Cinema 4D and Grayscale Gorilla. So yeah, next is practice. So this is a not so technical thing. It's just a basic thing to understand. Like this is the graph for performance measure, and this is the number of trials like you'll be doing in your journey. So definitely in the starting, it will be like very slow. Very slow. It will be like if you'll open a software, then definitely you find so many buttons out of it, you'll get confused. Like you'll not know where to start from. So you have to understand, you have to find some key points from the tutorials, like why they are pushing this button, why are they using this tool. So in the starting, there will be a like very slow beginning. Then eventually you'll start learning. There will be a steep acceleration when you'll understand things, then you'll know the tools, how to use it. Then you'll finally reach the plateau where you'll be knowing, like, I wouldn't say like most of it, but definitely like 20% or like 30% of it. So I think this will be a great thing if you'll achieve that much. So next on, like, you practice, practice, practice. That's the only thing which will make you succeed. So after practicing, use some references. So I used to play some games, watch some movies, so I use references from them. Like you can see this is game Far Cry and some game, this one was, I think, yeah, Far Cry only, and some of the trailers, some of the movies are there. You can get references out of it. You can use them, but don't copy it like properly. You can just take some of the design elements, some of the patterns, if you'll say. Use those things as your tool. Don't fully copy it because, you know, like copying is like totally stealing. Steal it, but in a like very smart way. So next on is like follow your favorite artist. So yeah, if you'll follow your favorite artist, then definitely your work will be gonna excel. Because see, this is Mike Winkelmann. This is some of my favorite artists which I'm following. This is Beeple. This is a great guy, Mike Winkelmann. So his thing is making artwork daily. So you can see 4,764 consecutive days. So he is making artwork every day, every single day. Till today, I think he's making. So since last 10 years, he's making artwork. Like every day he spends 1 hour for like one artwork, and he used to post it in social media. So this is a learning process for him. For you, it might be totally different. For me, I usually like take 3 to 4 days to make one artwork for myself. So this is my process. So yeah, Beeple is a great guy. You can follow him. This is his artwork. It's a really cool, some glass and architecture you can find here. This is another guy, Simon Hallmetal. He's a really FX guy. Most of the things are FX. Very eye-catching and abstract kind of art you'll see. This is a commercial for a mouse. You can see the particles, how it displaced. It's a really nice guy. Andrew Kramer, as you might all be knowing it, I think he's like the guru of After Effects. You can learn most of the things from him. Like if you can see the THX video of it, like you'll find so many stuff. Peter Taka is another guy. He's definitely elegant for illustrations. Like if you are a graphical student, you can definitely find his work really intriguing. Like so many patterns are there. If you'll find one circular is there, one square is there. So many squares are there and cubes are there. Like it's following a different pattern. So you can see like how the art works. You can use some of the elements of his. There's another great artwork. It's really complex, but you can definitely find some patterns, like two leaves are here and some of the tubes are here.